A merge sort based on multi-way merging has a memory transfer complexity of n over l log base z over l of n over l. So, is that good or bad? As it happens, it's as good as we could hope for, asymptotically speaking. Let's see why. You start with n items. And for simplicity, let's say that these items are unique. Initially, you haven't seen any of the items yet. So, all you know is that there are n factorial possible ways in which you might order the data, right? Yikes, that's a lot of orderings. Of these orderings, the goal of sorting is to find a specific one in which all the items are in, for example, ascending order. From this point of view, here's a sketch of one way to determine a lower bound. Suppose you read some data from slow memory. From this data, you learn something, which reduces the number of possible orderings. Now, let's be a teeny bit more precise. Suppose there have been t-1 transfers. Let k of t-1 denote the number of possible orderings that remain. And remember, initially there are n factorial such orderings. Suppose that after you do t-1 reads, you now do another read of block size l from slow memory to fast memory. If you've never seen these items before, then there are l factorial ways in which you can order them. Now, if there are any other items in fast memory already, let's suppose that you already know their relative ordering. So, how many ways can you order up to z minus l old items plus the l new items? It's at most z choose l times l factorial. This is the factor by which the number of possible orderings might go down. Then, after t reads, here's the lower bound on the number of possible orderings. It's n factorial divided by z choose l times l factorial quantity to the power t. Now this count is actually a little bit more conservative than necessary. The l factorial factor assumes that we don't know the order of the l items that we just read. But if you've read the l items before, then that won't be the case. That's because you can only perform n over l reads of items that have never been read together before. Thus, we can refine this estimate of the lower bound on k of t. In particular, l factorial to the t becomes l factorial to the n over l. We're almost done. What you want to know now is when does this right-hand side equal 1? That is, when does only one ordering remain? The smallest value of t such that this happens is our lower bound on the number of transfers. That turns out to be what we were after. N over l log base z over l of n over l. To get this result, you just need two common approximation identities plus a little algebra. I'll post a nice set of notes by Lars Arge that explains all this in detail in case you're interested. And you are definitely interested, because you love this stuff. You love it. That's you making out with the stuff. Shame on you. This is a family course.